the usage of the response headers. Now, first of all, we need to use we need to understand what is a response header, and then see, excuse me, how do we implement response headers with Selenium WebDriver codes. Now, first of all, we'll see what is a response header. So what is the response code? So when you are actually requesting something from the search engine or from a website, the request goes to the web server first. And you might have requested for a particular URL to open. If the URL is present and existing in the web server domain strategy level, it is going to send you a 3-digit HTTP response code stating that if the website can be opened. And there are a lot of response codes available, and you should know what are the response codes. For example, if I want to open google.com, so I give a request from my browser. If the response code from the server side of Google is 200, that means the URL is correct and it is existing, and it will open up the Google application in your browser. So for example, if I have requested for a google.com and the response code is 200, means what? It okay, here is the content you are asking for. It will open up the website for you. Now there are other response codes also available. Okay, one of the examples is 301. So if you are sending a request and the server is sending a response code of 301, it precisely means we have got you. The page has moved from the present location to some other location, and we will redirect you to the other location where the page has been removed. So there are examples of other response codes which are available in this Office document. So if you open this Office document, for example, sorry, this is not the page I'm looking at. I wanted to actually open up the Office document. So I'll just, this is the Office document. I'll just open it to show you so the other examples of response codes. So I've given you all the response codes out here. What do you mean by one series of response codes, two series of response codes, and three series of response code? You can just have a look at it. Now, for example, if you get 200, that means okay, the request is okay and the page is going to open in your browser. If it is 201, is the response code from the server side, the request is complete and a new resource is created. Similarly, if you have three series of response code, let's say 301, it means that the request page has moved to a new URL and it will redirect you. The browser will redirect you to the new URL. Four series of response codes. If you are getting 400 as a response code from your browser side, that means it's a bad request. The server did not understand the request that you have sent from the browser. The bad request can be terms of a bad URL, or the URL you have typed is not correct. It will show you 400 in your browser. 401 means unauthorized. The requested page needs to be having a username and password. So you can go through all the response codes present out here. Okay. Coming back to the presentation out here, as far as Selenium WebDriver is concerned, it does not support response codes. That means you cannot have any scripts through which you can, you know, create a condition that if this condition is matched, then only the script will perform some certain action. So for example, the example will be something like, let's say if the response code is 200, then only you should click on that particular link or on that particular page present in the link. Okay. So what we need to do is that, for example, let's say we want to click on a page or a link, and let's say the response code is 200. Response code 200 means the request sent by the client to open a website is correct and is existing. Now, if the code is 200 only, then only you have to click on a page or a link. If the code is not equal to 200, you don't have to click on the page or the link. The Selenium WebDriver do not have any classes or method to support this kind of condition. That means, for example, it should be 200, only the link should be clicked. If the response code is not equal to 200, the link should not be clicked. Okay. So Selenium does not have any kind of classes and method to support response code behavior. And let's say I want to have this condition in Selenium that if the response code is only 200, then only you should click on a link. This kind of condition cannot be met by using Selenium WebDriver API, because the Selenium WebDriver API doesn't have any classes and method to support response codes. So what we do, we use a third party jar file in order to implement response codes behavior in Selenium WebDriver scripts. Okay, as far as Selenium is concerned, as I have told you, it does not support response code. And you can look at this particular website out here. I can just show you this website if I open up Chrome. So if you go to this particular URL, it tells you that the WebDriver lacks HTTP response header and status code methods. That means WebDriver does not support response codes or response headers. And it tells you very, very clearly that we will not be adding this feature to the WebDriver API as it falls outside the current scope. So that is why there is no classes and methods through which you can create scripts as far as response codes are concerned. But there is a third party jar file called FluentHC jar file. Okay, and this is the URL out here. The URL is also given in your PPT. This is the URL, 9thavenue.com, how to get the HTTP status codes to work with Selenium WebDriver. So this is the URL that I have opened, and it tells you that you have to use a third party jar file called FluentHC with this particular version in order to implement the concept of response codes in Selenium WebDriver. So first, what we need to do is that we need to download FluentHC jar file 4.2.1. So I can go to Google and I can actually go to download FluentHC 4.2.1 jar file. I can download it from this particular URL, java2s.com. It's a fantastic URL to give you all versions of all jar files. I generally use this. So this is the FluentHC 4.2.1 jar.zip file. You can just download it and the zip file will get downloaded. You can open, show in the folder. I'll just copy it from here and paste it to my Selenium repo folder. And I'll extract this jar file. So extract it here only. This is the jar file that needs to be used. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to implement the jar file in this project called Selenium Trail. So right click, go to properties, go to Java build path, and go to libraries, add external jar files. Here I will go to your EG Selenium repo. This is the jar file to be used. Just add it to your project. Go to order and export. Select all. Say OK. Okay. So after that, I'm going to create a new class inside this package called clicking links. So I'll call this as using response codes. Okay, and I'll create a function for it. This function can be used in your Selenium codes. So I'll create a public static boolean return type function, and I'll call this as check code function. And check code, what I'm going to check, that the URL is present in the web browser or not, or web server or not. If the URL is correct and it is present in the web server, then only the URL should open in the website. So I'll call this as the URL as the parameter, string type parameter. And what is the code I need to write? The code is also given in this particular website called as how to get HTTP status code in Selenium WebDriver. Okay, the code is also given out here. I will just copy this code. And paste it to my function. Now if you look at this, the return type of the get status, you have to actually import the request class present in the Fluent package. And you have to also change, so this URL will be nothing but the parameter URL out there, so change it to capital URL. Okay, the return type of get status method is an integer, so I will return it to the integer x is equal to this much, and I will write down if, now what is the code that I am going to create? So look at the PPT out here. I am saying that if the response code is 200 thrown by the web server towards the client, then only open the URL. Otherwise, do not open the URL. So what you are supposed to do is that I will use that fluenthc.jar file and the codes of it to create a Selenium WebDriver scripts where I say that if the response code is 200, then only click on that particular link or open up that particular URL. Okay, so I'm going to create that particular code out here. So I'm saying that if the value of x is equal to 200, return true, else return false, because the return type is a boolean return type out here in the function, and the catch will, if it is not 200, obviously it is part of the try catch block, the exception will be caught and the catch body will be printed out, throw new exception, and then you can return false. Excuse me. Return true has to be with the terminator sign. Return false. You can remove this. Return false. So what I can do is that I can just check out this particular URL. So I just have to use the check code function inside the main method. The control spacebar, check code, what URL do you want to check in the string format you need to give. Let's say I want to check in HTTP colon double slash www.gmail.com, and let's say if the return x value is 200, then I should write down sys out the URL is existing, and if the value of x is not equal to 200, then I should write down sys out the URL does not exist. So we will check if this URL is existing or not. If the URL is existing, obviously I can get this message and the probably the website will be also navigated to. So I can have to use the web driver scripts out here. So what I will do is that I'll create a static WebDriver driver instance. Change to WebDriver, yes. And I'll put this function called check in an if statement. If the URL shows you, if the URL shows you the response code of 200, okay, with the condition, then you can actually I have to put this before this. So I have to first open the Firefox browser. So I'll just copy this code and put it out here. So navigating will be based on the fact that if the response code is 200, then only navigate to gmail.com. So driver.get string, and then you can write down http://www.gmail.com. So what I'm trying to do out here is that I'm going to call this check code function to check if the response code is 200 or not. If it is 200, it is going to print out this, okay, and navigate to gmail.com. So I've called the check code function as part of the if statement. So if the condition is true, then only navigate to gmail.com. If the condition is not true, when the condition is not true, when the value of x is not equal to 200. So when the value of x is not equal to 200, this condition will be false and it should not navigate. So right now, what is happening? Check this particular URL. Right now, the condition will be true because the value of x will be 200. Okay. So x is 200, it will navigate to gmail.com. So let's see, it will navigate right now. Let's see if it is working or not. And plus, it's also print out the URL is existing. So let's save this and run it. I will close this extra browser and run this class file. This is open up Firefox. And it has navigated to gmail.com, and that is why you are in the console, you are getting the URL existing. Now what I will do, I'll hamper the URL out here. If I hamper the URL, I will not get the response code to be equal to 200. So if it is not equal to 200, this will be printed out, and since this will be printed out, this condition will become false obviously, and it will not navigate to gmail.com. So what I'll do, I'll put it out here, the value of URL as, so this value, this I'm passing the parameter value which will be passed out here. So slash, for example, Zaran, let's say cup cake dot html. So I have hampered the URL right now. So you will not get a response of 200. So what will happen? It will throw out this particular printout in the console of Eclipse. So the condition will also become false. It should not navigate to gmail.com. So let's see if it is working or not. Save the class file and run it. I will close this browser first. It should not navigate to gmail.com because the URL is not existing. That means you are not getting the response term equal to 200 for the URL that you have given in check code. In check code function. What is the console result? The URL does not exist. That means this URL is not existing. That is why the value of x is not equal to 200. So it is printing out this particular printout command and it is not navigating to gmail.com. And that's what you see in the Firefox browser. It has not navigated to gmail.com. So that's about it of implementing the response code with Selenium WebDriver code.